Amid all of this, President Trump is heading to Minneapolis right now for a political rally tonight. Our chief White House correspondent Jim Acosta is on the scene for us in Minneapolis. Jim, new complications for the Trump team tonight.
That's right, Wolf. The president is on his way to Minneapolis for this rally tonight. But before he left the White House, he talked to reporters. He was asked about those two Giuliani associates who are facing federal charges. The president said he didn't know those two associates of Rudy Giuliani. He didn't know what they were up to. He said when asked about their activities over in Ukraine, he told reporters, "You'll have to ask Rudy." With two men involved in his personal attorney Rudy Giuliani's efforts to dig up dirt on Joe Biden, now suddenly indicted on campaign finance violations, President Trump sounded off to reporters as he left for a rally in Minneapolis.
I don't know them. I don't know about them. I don't know what they do. But I don't know. Maybe they were clients of Rudy. You'd have to ask Rudy. I just don't know.
The arrests of Giuliani associates Igor Fruman and Lev Parnas as they were allegedly trying to flee the country are only adding to calls from Democrats for the president's outside lawyer to testify in the impeachment inquiry.
Giuliani's been involved up to his neck in this entire mess. He has an obligation to testify under oath so he can be asked questions and so this can come to light.
The president's lead impeachment lawyer, Jay Sekulow, responded in a brief statement, "Read the indictment. Neither the candidate nor the campaign have anything to do with the scheme these guys were involved in." But photos are surfacing of Fruman and Parnas meeting with Mr. Trump and his family. Giuliani was just boasting earlier this week that he wants to tell his story to lawmakers.
"I would love to testify, and give me a half hour to point out Biden Inc., 4 decades of crime. I'd love to do it."
The president continues to blast the fast-moving impeachment proceedings, tweeting, "The president of the Ukraine just stated again in the strongest of language that President Trump applied no pressure and did absolutely nothing wrong."
They have eviscerated the rules. They don't give us any fair play. It's the most unfair situation people have seen. No lawyers, you can't have lawyers, you can't speak, you can't do anything. You virtually can't do anything.
But past supporters are coming forward to criticize the president's call on the leader of Ukraine to investigate Biden and his family, including Mr. Trump's former national security advisor, H.R. McMaster.
"Do you think it is appropriate for the president of the United States to solicit foreign interference in our political process? Thank you.
Of course, no. No, it's absolutely not."
George Conway, husband of White House counselor Kellyanne Conway, has formed a group of conservatives slamming Mr. Trump's actions, saying in a statement, "These acts, based on what have been revealed to date, are a legitimate basis for an expeditious impeachment investigation." Conway told CNN contributor Preet Bharara the White House refusal to cooperate with the impeachment probe doesn't hold up.
"The thrust of it is that there are some kind of constitutional obligations that the House has failed to meet that therefore render its impeachment inquiry illegitimate and unconstitutional, which is complete nonsense, because all the Constitution says is that the House has the sole power of impeachment."
No doubt.
The president is lashing out at a new Fox News poll, finding 51% want to see Mr. Trump impeached and removed from office, tweeting, "I have never had a good Fox News poll. Whoever their pollster is, they suck."
Jim Acosta reporting for us from Minneapolis. Let's get some more on all of this. Democratic Congressman Ted Lieu of California is joining us. He's a member of both the Judiciary and Foreign Affairs Committees. Congressman, thanks so much for joining us. So what does it tell you that these two associates of Rudy Giuliani are now charged by the federal government with conspiracy to buy political influence?
Thank you, Wolf, for your question. We have a clear pattern here. In 2016, Russia interfered in our elections and helped Donald Trump. In 2018, we now know that these two associates, Rudy Giuliani, helped funnel hundreds of thousands of dollars of foreign money to a pro-Trump super PAC. And then last month, we learned that the President of the United States solicited Ukraine to target his American political opponent. We're all Americans, and we cannot have the American president continue to receive or solicit illegal assistance from foreign powers.
How will this indictment, Congressman, impact your ability to get documents, to get testimony from these two men?
So I'm on two of the committees of jurisdiction. And on foreign affairs oversight, which is being led in this investigation by the Intel Committee, we've sent out subpoenas to those two associates of Rudy Giuliani's. As you know, we also have recently subpoenaed Rick Perry. We have subpoenaed numerous other witnesses. And why are there so many subpoenas? It's because we're seeing epic corruption. Corruption at an unprecedented level among senior White House staff, going all the way up potentially to the president.
What questions do you have for Rudy Giuliani at this point?
It is very suspicious timing that right after his two associates had a lunch with him, that they immediately tried to escape the country. And they were thankfully stopped by law enforcement at Dulles Airport. I want to know what Rudy Giuliani knew about the funneling of money to a pro-Trump super PAC, about what the associates were doing and trying to get a member of Congress, then Congressman Pete Sessions, to write a letter criticizing the former U.S. ambassador. This is all very corrupt, very shady. We want to get answers.
House Democrats have also, as you know, subpoenaed the Energy Secretary Rick Perry for documents. The administration has made it clear, though, it won't cooperate. So how likely is it that you get any information from Secretary Perry?
If Secretary Perry wants to clear his name, he would come in and testify and provide documents. If he did nothing wrong, he would give the information for the American people to see. What we already do know is that Donald Trump cut off military aid to Ukraine. And then about a week later, he had a phone call with the Ukrainian president. And right after the Ukrainian leader raises the issue of military aid, Donald Trump asked for a favor. One of those is to target Biden. And then we know there was a full-on pressure campaign to get Ukraine to target and investigate the Bidens. This was not a one-off conversation that Donald Trump had. It was a full-on campaign. We want to know what Rick Perry's involvement was in that campaign.
You're scheduled to also hear from the former U.S. ambassador to Ukraine, Marie Yovanovitch, tomorrow morning. Are you confident that that will go ahead as scheduled, or do you expect the Trump administration to intervene and prevent her? She still works at the State Department, from appearing.
I wouldn't be surprised if the Trump administration continues to obstruct and prevent her testimony, but she is free to come and she is free to speak her mind and provide information and documents, just as Ambassador Volker did. And we understand that she was recalled earlier and she is not particularly someone that is a loyalist to some of these enablers of Donald Trump. I think she has a story to tell and the American people should be able to hear her
But
story.
The difference is that Ambassador Kurt Volker, who was the special envoy to Ukraine, he had resigned a few days earlier, so he was a private citizen when he went and answered questions before the committee. She still is a U.S. government employee. She's a career diplomat, a foreign service officer.
She is, but she's getting a formal request from Congress to appear and testify about potential misconduct in our federal government. I believe she has every right to come forward and to give that testimony, and I expect her to come forward.
Well, what if Secretary Pompeo says you can't go?
Then we will subpoena her as well. And Secretary Pompeo needs to be careful because I don't think he would want to have an article of impeachment leveled against him for obstruction of Congress.
We've also learned, Congressman, that a political appointee over at the Office of Management and Budget, Michael Duffy, was involved in freezing that U.S. military assistance to Ukraine. And career officials raised lots of concerns about whether that potentially broke the law. Do you want Duffy to testify in your investigation?
Absolutely. And again, this new development shows that this was not a random conversation Donald Trump had with the Ukrainian president. It was very clearly deliberate that Donald Trump halted critical military aid, and then they pass it off to a political appointee to continue withholding that military aid, even though it was likely illegal. And they kept doing that. And then they sent Mike Pence to tell the Ukrainian leader that aid was still withheld. They were continuing to pressure the Ukrainians to investigate Biden. This is so wrong on so many levels. It's un-American. It's corrupt. It's a betrayal of our values.
Congressman Ted Lieu, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Woe.